Good morning, you guys. Welcome back to another video. It is Monday, so we are starting off another vlog. It's a new week, and I always have so much motivation to pick up my camera and just start a new vlog once a new week hits, so that's what I'm doing. This is just another week of my life in quarantine. I was thinking about how cool, almost, getting to document and vlog my life right now, because this is such a new thing and who knows if this will ever happen again, or I mean, pray to God it doesn't. But once this is all over, maybe in a few months, in a few years, I can watch these videos and be like, damn, we were all going through this thing and it sucked, but here's how I made the most of it. It'll remind me to just be grateful and not take just basic everyday sort of things for granted, because I sure as hell miss being able to go to the gym or to the shopping mall or go hang out with my friends. Like, simple things that, you know, were just everyday activities for me, and now I just can't do that. That's why I've been trying to do as many of these quarantine vlogs as I can without, you know, tiring myself out. That's why I took a little break last week, but I'm back. I'm about to head out of the house, run a few errands, and also work out. I think I'm gonna go on a run, which I've been doing a lot more of since this whole quarantine thing has been going on. My room is a complete mess right now. As you can see, I've got, even though I just cleaned it, like really cleaned it a couple weeks ago, but I recently had to move back all my stuff from my sorority house in San Jose back home. So my senior year is like officially over, kind of, minus the fact that I'm still taking classes online. But yeah, I don't live in college anymore. So sad and empty. Cleaning out my room. That's why I have all these plastic drawers here. I just go through them, fold them, put them back in my normal drawers, and then I also have like boxes and trash and things that I ordered. I just have some putting away to do. I'm gonna get to that eventually this week, and I also have a ton of studying to do because tomorrow I have a midterm, and just the usual other school stuff and YouTube. So let's get this week started. I took my pre-workout like 10-ish minutes ago, so I'm good to go. I just charged up my Fitbit. This is what I'm wearing for my run. These Fabletic leggings are the bomb, because having side pockets for my run is crucial, because then I can just run free hands, you know. And then it's really cold out, so I'm just wearing a cropped hoodie with like a sports bra under. This one's nice and lightweight. Oh my god, so I actually finished my run like 20-ish minutes ago, and so I've just been stretching outside and just cooling off, because when I finished my run, I was bright red and it was literally so scary. Thank God I don't get Asian glow when I drink, because this is what I would look like. I ran 4 miles just now, and I actually used to do this run like every other day in high school, either during my lunch break or after school, which now when I think about it, I'm like, oh God, I don't even know if I would want to do this ever again. I guess I just enjoyed running a whole lot more in high school because that's really all I knew. I played volleyball and I ran. That was about it, because I didn't start weightlifting at that time. I've been easing myself back into running longer distances and just like doing more cardio, because I strayed away from it for the longest time. I did not let myself stop to walk, because I knew that if I did, I probably wouldn't start running again. So I just ran the whole thing, and I feel good now. Anyways, that was fun. Now I need to go to Target and pick up a few things. Got my bag and my mask. I don't have a super fancy mask or anything, but something is better than nothing, I suppose. I have this black one. It's made out of like a, I don't even know what kind of material this is. But then I put a cloth one over it, so I'm just doubling up. And my ears are really small. I got some gloves. These ones are really thick. Really, this is crazy to me. I have to do all of this, but better safe than sorry. I'm in the middle of my Target run right now, and for once they finally have acetone anywhere. Check Targets, Walgreens, all that, because
my gel manicure has been on my nails for so long, and I've been waiting for so long that I actually peeled everything off already, but I'm getting it from my sister. So far we're doing good. Just picking up some food items for breakfast. It's getting real hot in this thing. I miss you, 24-hour fitness. We'll meet again soon. So back home, this is my quick little haul of what I got at Target. Flax milk, because they didn't have any oat milk, no almond milk. I've tried this before and it's not too bad. I just use this in my protein shakes. Got some bananas, Yogi detox tea, big thing of strawberries, and a yellow Red Bull because I'm gonna need this later today because I have a lot of studying to do. Alrighty, found ourselves a good spot. I'm here at the library. I got a whole table to myself. This is awesome. If you're confused, I'm doing a little bit of role play here. I showered after coming home and I just got ready and put on like a normalish outfit, put on a little bit of makeup, just brows and mascara, just to feel a little bit more put together. And I'm really just trying to get myself in more of a school mode. Doing online school is really difficult, especially for me, because I tend to get distracted easily. And if I'm just like too comfortable in my own room or whatever, then I'm not like as motivated to do work. So pro tip for you guys, get ready for your class. Go to an environment where you know you can get more work done. Just set yourself up for productivity. My classes have been online for over a month now, and this is like the first midterm that I'm actually taking from home. Some habits have stayed with me, unfortunately. Procrastination. My exam is tomorrow. So we're gonna be here for a while. I'm gonna pretend like this is the 7th floor of MLK Library. I'm facing the window. My favorite spot in the library, you know? I'm feeling good. Right, Mama? Good morning, you guys. It is Tuesday. Actually, no, sorry. It's Tuesday, but it's not the morning. It's already 1:32. I had breakfast, watched YouTube videos, and then started studying some more because I have to take my exam today. I feel prepared for it, and honestly, I shouldn't even be too worried because it's literally open notes, open textbook. I'm gonna take my exam on this laptop. I'm gonna use my dad's laptop to look up my like e-textbook. Then I have this really long study. I like, look at that. It's really like 17 pages of material. All which I did last night, back and forth through my textbook from the lecture sides and just copying and pasting. This is just my specific professor's policy that he allows open notes. And even before classes got moved online, everyone has their laptop out with tabs on tabs on tabs and their notebook and their iPad. It definitely takes a little bit of stress off knowing I have the resources in front of me. Anyways, I'm lollygagging. I'll check in with you afterwards. Wish me luck. The sirens outside. They're going crazy, holy. That's a little concerning. It is a scary world that we live in now. I had a really nice, relaxing morning. I had my breakfast and tea outside on our deck. It's Wednesday and I didn't have class, but I was still doing a little bit of schoolwork. I have another exam tomorrow that I also need to prepare for. So I've been doing that for the bulk of my day and eyes feel so fuzzy right now. When I look at my camera, I'm seeing double. I've been staring at my computer screen all day. I also took a little nap. I don't even think I vlogged after my exam on Tuesday, but it went really well. This exam that I have tomorrow is for my quantitative business analysis class, and it is so difficult, and it's honestly kicking my ass, but we're gonna get through it. Last night, I stayed up really freaking late because I was up editing a video for TikTok. I had finished putting together the video at like 1 a.m. last night. I just decided to wait till today to post it. One of my friends who I met essentially through YouTube, Elliot Choi, he just recently posted a TikTok and it showed up on my For You page of the story of how he met Jimmy Fallon. And we actually met on that trip, used his sound, and like I did my own version of it, even though it was basically the same thing. What people always say, don't let this flop. I don't think this is gonna flop. We're just gonna see how this goes. Follow me on there if you want. I'm not like super serious about it. It's just for fun and it's entertaining.
All right, let's do it. Hell yeah, it's uploaded. Let's see how it goes.
All right, it's time to work out. What time is it? I don't even know, but it's probably like almost 4 p.m. I was productive, but I need to get moving. Something active, so I'm gonna do a quick little, actually no, it's not gonna be quick. I just wanna take my time with it, have fun. With these home workouts that I've been doing lately, I give myself lots of time, like a good 2 hours of just moving, listening to music. Goes to prove that you really don't need a gym to get a good sweat in. I used a couple sets of dumbbells. Luckily I have like a 5 pound set, 10 pound set, and then 12 pound set. And then also I used like my bed or like a chair for the tricep dips. And then the rest of it was basically just body weight. So my upper body is feeling so good right now. Oh my God. I'm tired, but I'm rejuvenated in a weird way. That's what working out does for me. Even though I exert so much energy doing it, afterwards I just feel so brand new.
Wow, post-workout meal. That is a lot of pasta. I should probably not eat all of that. Got some Alfredo pasta with salmon, spinach, and bell peppers.
Shout out to my mom. The noodles are like al dente. Kind of hard, but good.
The model I use is 130, so international twist, if you will, on this intangible product.
All right. I'm so scared to take this freaking test. Studied, but I'm still real leaner this. Ah! Oh my god, okay, okay. I don't wanna do this. Good afternoon. Ew, I sound so proper when I say that. Hi, okay, it's like 1:30 right now and I'm about to take my last midterm for this week. It'll be like the end of my midterm season. Oh, what a relief. I had class at 9 on Zoom and then 10:30 I had a quiz to take for another class, and then now it is like almost 1:30, so now it's time for my final class of the day. It's not even due until like 8 p.m. tonight, so I could take it later on today, but I'm just like, I've been thinking about it and I've just been so anxious about it. I'm just mentally preparing myself for that right now. Notebook, check. Pencil and eraser, check, because I'm gonna have to like work through my problems and then take a picture of my work and send it in. Calculator, check. Oh god, oh god. I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous.
Ah! Oh my god, come on.
I'm nervous. I want to take this exam.
You're not ready, this one?
It's just hard. It's math and a lot of weird computer. Oh. I really just want to go outside and relax and work out, but I gotta take care of this first. Okay, okay. It's fine. Happy thoughts, happy thoughts. Oh my god, we made it. I survived. That exam was killer. I just finished another sort of group project thing for another class. So, my school day has officially come to an end. And now I'm gonna work out. I was actually talking to a friend about this earlier today, and I feel like I get a lot of questions on how I stay motivated to work out. I know especially during this time it can be hard to get moving, although all of us are stuck at home. People still have things going on. It's not like life just went on hold and now we have all the time in the world. People still have school, have to study, have to go to work. Always gonna be difficult to balance all the things we need and want to do in life, but I think it's just more of a mindset type of thing. I feel like I talk about it a lot, but I feel very strongly on it. Working out to me is just that little bit of time that I give myself every single day to just do my own thing. If you still feel like you don't have time in your day or your week to work out, either at the beginning of your day or the end of the day, put in a little time block right there. Set aside the time to do it because you're gonna feel so much better. It's such a great way to start off your day or reward yourself after a hard day of doing schoolwork, for example. The time of day when I work out always varies for me depending on what I'm doing, but for today, since I'm working out like after I finish all my school stuff, this is like my treat to myself. Obviously, it's not gonna be the same for everyone. A lot of people probably dread working out and it's the last thing that they wanna do, but that's why experimenting with different type of workouts is great. Yoga, running, weights, bands, plyometrics, I don't know, all of the above. Every single day, I try to switch it up a little. It's definitely been a challenge for me to stay excited and stay creative with the workouts I'm doing at home since I don't have access to a gym, but in the end it's all fun for me. I just went on a really long tangent, but I feel like it's stuff that I want to talk to you guys about because I know some of you are probably struggling out there, and I just want to like share my outlook. I know there are people watching these vlogs and I know at least one person is gonna need that little bit of motivation, and I want to be that motivator for you because I'm like, I stan my mentality during this quarantine and I just want to spread that with you guys. Duh. I haven't even taken my pre-workout yet, but I'm all pumped and ready. Balls to the walls already. Shout out to Stax. Pre-workout is the bomb. So good. I feel like doing some lower body today, so I'm gonna do some legs. I did a whole upper body workout, mostly in my shoulders, and they're actually really sore today, which I'm super happy about.
This is pretty much the extent of the equipment that I have, maybe like a couple extra resistance bands and whatever, but two sets of weights. I have this one single kettlebell, which really soon I'm gonna share a kettlebell workout that I put together recently. So stay tuned for that. It'll be in my next video or maybe on Instagram. And then I have like different types of resistance booty bands.
Play music off of my iPad. And if you're not following me on Spotify, now is the time to do it because I have so many different workout playlists and I've been adding to them a lot. I have like 5 or 6 different ones. And then I have a ton of other playlists that might set your vibe. Whatever vibe you're feeling, you can take a look and hopefully I have something for you. For a leg day, I'm thinking something a little bit more hardcore. So we're gonna go with workout 2.0. This is like my headbangery type of stuff.
You want to join my workout? No, you can't. You really need to work on your legs though. Look at those scrawny little things. Okay, Alice, come. Come on. Oh, you're so cute.
Days. That's a long time for me because usually I wash it every single day. Naturally just gets super oily and I hate going to bed when my hair is dirty. For the past few days I've just been throwing in a braid and going to sleep like that, but it's not that time. So I'm gonna shower and hop into bed because it's already like 10 o'clock. We're back and better than ever. I'm gonna use my Function of Beauty leave-in conditioner, give my hair some extra loving, you know? My hair is getting so long. Oh, I miss my girl Megan at Bishop's, which is where I get my hair cut in San Jose. Pretty sure the last time I got my hair cut was in like November, October. Really long time ago, and I had only gotten trimmed. Probably the biggest reason why I like having my hair so long is that when it's up while I play sports or while I'm working out, I like having a long ponytail and being able to put it in a nice bun. But when it's down, it just, I feel like it drags me down. And I think that's the thing. You have long hair, it makes you appear visually shorter. That's just how the eye works, you know? Not that that's a concern for me, but I just feel like my hair drags me down sometimes. But it made me good and weighed it out. This leave-in conditioner is so good. It smells amazing. So I'm just gonna put a little bit more of that on my ends. Also, let's do a face mask tonight. This one is from Tula. I love Tula skincare. I first tried Tula skincare like a couple years ago because Whitney Simmons recommended it. I had pretty bad acne a couple years ago, and so I totally switched my skincare and just used Tula products and Curology as well. This is their star. Oh, it's dripping. Oh my god, oh my god. Don't let the serum go to waste, y'all. It's good stuff. Oh. Oh. So slimy and slippery. I can't even grab it. Oh my god, it's so pretty. Oh, wow. It has stars on it. Oh, it feels so good. This one is their Star Bright Nourishing and Brightening Cosmic Hydrogel Mask. Oh, that just sounds amazing. Also, a really cool thing about these masks is that if you order them off of Tula's site, they're doing this mask for mask thing where if you get a mask, you give a mask. Proceeds for this product are going directly to a donation for masks for people who need them right now, which is awesome because it's skincare because you care. I just did a little Instagram story to share with y'all. I think it's really cool how companies are doing these charitable sort of things with their purchases. Definitely one way to help everything that's going on right now. Alright you guys, so that is going to conclude this vlog. I hope you enjoyed. If you actually watched through the whole thing and made it to this point, I appreciate you a lot. By the time you're watching this, it'll be the next week, so like Monday. Hope this gives you some motivation to start off this week on the right foot. It did take me a while to get this vlog up though because there was so much footage and like I kept trying to sit down and edit everything, but I had to keep taking breaks. I got it up though, and that's all that really matters. If you guys enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not already. That is it for this video. I will see you guys in the next one.